That's why Dr. Group is here with us. Dr. Group, former Army operative in his own right, and then, of course, holds many different medical degrees. You can find out more at InfoWars.com in the bio section of our guest, or at GlobalHealingCenter.com. Dr. Group will be with us for the balance of the hour. Then David Knight takes over in the fourth hour. And I had a whole stack of news for why he was coming on the show today and what he was going to be discussing. Flu season peaking later than usual. That's the Idaho State Journal. Stanton community grieves after educator dies from complications from the flu, and it's killing people in the lungs. Flu season hits new highs, but massive vaccinations happen, and people say, you need to take the shot so I don't get sick, but they're the people that have taken it that are dying so many times. I mean, if you're protected, then you're protected, I thought. Flu season hits new highs, and it's going so late. We have another article, others dying that are prominent. So it just expands. North Carolina reports 8 more deaths from influenza. We're going to be breaking this down. But Merle Haggard dead at 79. Certainly some sad news. But his great music will live on forever. The Hag is dead. Now, I guess I could try to call up Willie Nelson. I haven't hung out with him in a while, but he's friends. And maybe get his take on this. But what we really want to do is take this sad death and draw attention to more and more of these mystery illnesses that are out there. And the studies that admit, when you take the regular flu shot, it doubles your chances of getting the flu the next year and lowers your immunity. But that's not something they tell people. They tell them just get the flu shot every year, even though they've had studies out for 20 years that 3 consecutive flu shots in a 3-year period doubles your chances of early onset of Alzheimer's. So we're going to discuss all of this with Dr. Edward Group, also one of the top formulators of products at InfoWarsLife.com. Doc, thanks for coming in today.
Thanks for having me on. Appreciate it.
This really underlines or highlights what you were already coming in to talk about. 1 minute, 2 minutes before you're going on, the Hag is dead. Weldon comes running in here. Country music singer in his own right. Pretty darn successful. And then it's on the same subject you were about to cover. That is weird.
It is weird. What's weird is what happened to me about 3 weeks ago. I was with my family on spring break in Utah, Park City, Deer Valley, where we go every year. And when I got there, I looked in the sky and I saw chemtrails everywhere. And my wife said to me, oh my gosh, look at all these chemtrails everywhere. And so we started walking around the town and everybody was coughing and hacking and has respiratory illnesses. And people were actually saying, I was asking a couple of people, I said, what's going on around here? And they said, well, they're calling it the Park City flu. And so I didn't think anything of it. And I ski for a couple of days. And on day 3, I start feeling really bad. And I'm looking up. I'm like, great. Now my whole vacation's going to be ruined. I don't even get sick. I know that if I get sick, there's something seriously going on. And I can literally feel it in my body. And I know that when there's something man-made or there's something strange or some sort of biological weapon, that there's something else going on. So I'm knocked out in bed, can't even move. I'm drinking 3 bottles of silver a day. I'm taking 100 drops of oregano. I'm taking a bunch of iodine. And I'm barely getting by. My throat, my respiratory, everything is going on. So like on day 3, I could finally start getting to the computer. So I started looking and saying, there's something weird going on. I need to find out what it is. So I'm thinking it's spring break all over the country. It's going to be spring break for the next 3 weeks. That's the perfect time for them to spray. And you know, everybody leaves their hometown for spring break, right? So they're all going to the East Coast. They're all going to the West Coast. They're going to Arizona. They're going skiing in Colorado and Utah. So I started looking at the different chemtrail websites and trying to figure out what's going on. Sure enough, I came up with, you know, digging deep enough with chemtrail flu and realized that they heavily sprayed the East Coast, right along the border of Canada and the United States. So the whole north, they squared in the United States.
And by the way, they cover a lot of this with geoengineering. It's admitted they're doing it. There are UN treaties on it. They have proven they are retrofitting planes. They also add key compounds to jet fuel, so it's compartmentalized. We have the patents, so even the companies don't know. They're directed by Homeland Security just to do it. That's why even NASA admits the Earth is now 30% darker. You can type in satellite images of chemtrails from space. That's the layman's term, but this is going on. There's also low-altitude spraying going on. They admit CIA testing in almost every city of the U.S., in some cases spraying chemicals, biologicals, radiologicals on towns, then having the military doctors in the hospitals to, quote, test the response. So secret human testing is massive. Most of the public only knows about black people and Tuskegee because they wanted the public to know and think, oh, it's just the black people. No, folks. No, they've been injecting large parts of the population with syphilis in the vaccines. You think it's a vaccine, it's really syphilis. My grandmother got polio from the polio vaccine 1 week later. This is a massive eugenics operation, as Prince Philip talked about. Please continue.
So, of course, me being a researcher, I wanted to dive into this even more. And at the same time, by the way, we're getting emails from people that are sick all over the nation. This has been going on, like I said, about 3 weeks ago it started. And I don't even think we're in the real big, you know, pandemic part of it yet.
Let's be clear. People get tested and don't even have the flu virus. They just say, people I know in Austin, because I've taken people to the doctor and they said this, well, we just call it the flu. We don't know what it is.
This is definitely not the flu. I mean, they're going in and they're getting flu shots, obviously. They're being told it's influenza, but the research that I pulled up, it's not. And we can link all these things with the pneumonia and the respiratory and the heart conditions that are going on over the all of across the U.S. Like I said, they sprayed not only in all, they not only did they square in the U.S., but they also sprayed right across the middle of the U.S. That's why you're seeing all these deaths and everything happen along the East Coast, the West Coast, along the South, and everything else.
And Merle Haggard just died. So
from
a respiratory deal.
So I pulled up some sample. There's an agency in Victoria, British Columbia, because whatever they're doing up there is really taking a bad people are having really bad reactions. And this samples were given to this lab that are licensed by the Environmental Protection Agency, and they found ethylene dibromide, which is a pesticide, a banned pesticide, which causes severe respiratory reactions at low levels. They found Pseudomonas aeruginosa, which not only causes respiratory infection, but also attacks the immune system. I told my wife, I said, it feels like there's three organisms that are attacking me at once. That was before I knew this, and sure enough, they identified three organisms. The second one is Serratia marcescens, which is an antibiotic-resistant bacteria which causes pneumonia, endocarditis, and meningitis, and the last one was Streptomyces and molds, capable of inducing heart disease, upper respiratory...
That's right. They now admit there's all these weird mutated molds that are killing the bats, killing the turtles, cause people to have heart attacks. Brain tumors are growing in young people suddenly from mold. Molds getting through the blood-brain barrier and then molds growing in the brain. I mean, what have they done with a GMO? Also, China heats up its big factories right now. Its jet stream dumps in all over the United States. So this is insane.
Top it off with the aluminum nanoparticles that they're spraying down on us and everything else.
Which is an admitted giant secret program. They admit they're doing it. Millions being spent spraying us with aluminum. And Monsanto's coming out with seeds that can grow in aluminum soil. And then
exactly.
You got the Zika virus, which they admit is linked to mutations and engineered, with the Rockefeller Foundation creating it, a souped-up version.
Right. I mean,
you cannot make this up.
You cannot make it up. It's happening. If you talk to farmers all over the world, the aluminum nanoparticles are causing a very acidic soil, messing up all the plants, including organic foods and beverages, and it's something that needs to be stopped, obviously.
That's why most of it has to be raised down in a greenhouse to be organic. Because you test it and it's got aluminum in it because it's raining out of the sky.
That's what we're doing. We're setting up greenhouses at our farm to grow all the herbs just so we can protect them from the air.
Just there. I want to get more into these news articles about this and why you think it's going to get a lot worse with Dr. Group or Joe Biggs briefly, because I'd forgotten, seeing him walk around the office, that he was in the hospital. Sickest he'd been in his life. He always brags he doesn't get sick. They couldn't say it was flu, couldn't say it was pneumonia, had pneumonia. And this is just all over the country, and the media's not really reporting on it. I mean, it's here or there, but... this is scary. Then you have congressional hearing reports where they call chemtrails an exotic weapon system. It's going on. All sorts of different cocktails are being sprayed on us. And they tell us it's ice crystals. Until the early 90s, when the Nobel Prize was won for coming up with this, a Nobel Prize was won for it, there were no chemtrails, condensation trails, ice crystals formed above 20,000 feet in the summer. A little bit lower in the winter, it was ice crystals, and they faded away within a minute. I sit there and watch these working in the garden or whatever. Spray, they're there 3 hours later, expanding and drifting down, forming cloud banks. They teach kids in university textbooks, but also in elementary textbooks, the entire gamut, that there's a program to save the Earth from solar radiation. It's a government program, and it is anti-human and poisoning the Earth. Joe Biggs, tell folks what happened to you.
It was interesting. I was just sitting at my desk, and I was listening to Dr. Group speak about the matter and how they were this huge chemtrail dump up north. So I was just recently in Philly. You know, 2 weeks prior to that, I was deathly ill. I was in the hospital on and off. I lost about 10 pounds. All I could do was sleep. I had no energy. I felt like I was on my deathbed. I woke up in cold sweats, and it reminded me because when I was in Philly, I had a conversation at the Democracy Spring protest. I was actually speaking to one of the older gentlemen that lived out there his whole life, and he says, hey, man, make sure you stay warm. He's like, you don't want to catch the pneumonia that's going around. And I said, that's funny you say that. I just had the flu and pneumonia. And he goes, man, he's like, you probably got the chemtrail flu. And that's what they're calling it right now in Philly. This is coming from a bunch of Bernie supporters, some Trump guys that are out there I spoke to. A lot of people are getting, a lot of people are dying from pneumonia.
And notice how the public knows. Even people that aren't listeners know about the chemtrail flu. People know that we've got an evil, multinational, global force against us. It's not aliens, but it might as well be. It's a global secret technocracy that uses all of our tax money to build these huge Manhattan Project programs and then use them against us.
Yeah, the last time I had the flu, I was like 12 years old. You know, I got, when I joined the military, when they started forcing us to take those flu shots, I would get sick from time to time. But I mean, this was the full-on flu. I'm in the bed, then I was able to get pneumonia. I mean, I literally thought I was going to die a couple days there. It was so bad that I didn't even know who I was speaking to. I couldn't walk. I fell over. And that's when I had to get someone to help me, drag me, pick me up, and take me to the hospital. They took all these tests. They found out that I had flu A. And then they did chest x-rays. They ended up finding out that I had pneumonia as well. On top of that, I thought I was going to die. So this is something that people really need to look into. You know, the fact that
notice the more vaccines we get, the worse it gets. Joe, thank you. We're glad you didn't go the way of Merle Haggard. Amazing. Tell folks what's coming up. We're going to break some of the U.S. code.
Okay, so as I was looking into it even more, H.R. 2977 is a bill that was introduced into the 107th U.S. Congress in 2001, and chemtrails were referred to as an exotic weapon system. And supposedly, chemtrail spraying over humans in the U.S. gained its legality from U.S. Code Title 50, Section 1520, which gives the Secretary of Defense authority to order testing involving the use of a chemical agent or biological agent on civilian population for research purposes.
That's right. Well, U.S. Code Title 50, Chapter 32, Subsection 1528, Paragraph B, quote, prohibits secret testing, including lethal, unless it's for research or law enforcement purposes.
Yeah.
So it's okay to kill us or test on us. It was for research or law enforcement purposes.
Yeah, that's right. And what people don't realize is when they block the UVB rays, this is a whole nother eugenics program. You block the body and the plant's ability to grow properly, and you block vitamin
E. And that's why Cass Sunstein at the White House wants a law banning saying sunlight is good. He wants a law where your kids aren't allowed to have it. It's child abuse.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Joseph Kleider for AscensionPathway.com on the Evan Fain YouTube channel. Bring you another episode of Grid Work, geoengineering on a daily basis. Today is Friday, April 8th, 2016. They made it rain. You saw what they did the last previous 2 days. They got up a bunch of red bad boys during the course of the night, early morning. Could hear how low they were under the soot to create the thunder sound. Okay, the only hole, why am I showing you this? It's the only hole in the grid. Everything else is just polluted toxic waste in their sky. Look at this. See what I'm saying? Little tiny hole there. That's about it. It's about 3:30. They made it rain. Really fake rain. You can see how black it is. Edge of the grid right here. And fortunately for us, they're not spraying, right? They're not trying to cover this hole. Maybe they feel they've done enough damage. I don't know. But for further proof, you can see the white soot just falling out of them cloudoids. They did a good job of fluffing them up, but they don't fool us awake people. Well, standing out in the middle of the road, it's about 4:30 in the afternoon, Eastern Sector. Look at that size of that grid. Look at that soot. A little cartoon inside there. Well, we got a nice hole in the grid right here, right above me. No active spraying either. You can see the white soot falling out of the cloudoids. People think these are clouds, guess again. Look at the soot falling. Look how it's all dispersing here. Look how it's just collapsing in front of your eyes. Clouds aren't supposed to do that. Not any clouds I ever learned about. Look how nasty this looks in that western sector by the mountain. Just look how polluted that looks. I mean, even the cloudoids just look toxic as all hell. Look at that. You can see the soot. It's a little bit of a sunlight coming through there. Look at that. See that? My God. Look over here where it should be blue. It's all white. So it all collapses. Like I said before, they want you to forget the sky was ever blue. Now as we look into this northern sector, you can see the soot falling out of the sky there. Possible raining, but you can see how the difference between the rain and the soot look. Okay, let me back this off and get some clarity here. Because if it was rain, you'd see it come down. It's just floating up there in the sky. Look how nasty these cloudoids look. Take your aid in there. It looks like some toxic plume. It just exploded in our sky. Here's that eastern sector part of the grid again. You can see how it's all canopied, just thick as a big log, big toxic log, I like to call it. But they did make it rain. Sun's not blocked right at the moment, but it's gonna be. You can bet your sweet butt on that. Well, it's 6 o'clock right on the button. Just happened to come outside and I haven't seen any railers because they've had it so thick and trying to make it rain, and they did. But look at this here. They're back at it. He just placed that and left it. Black soot up here, starting to fall. See the black soot? Got some white up here. That'll all collapse real soon here. But you can see how black it is in that western sector. It's just a big globule of black soot. And here comes that guy. There he is right there. He turned it off and turned it on. Wait till he gets a little closer, if he still has it on. White wisps up here already coming apart from previous chemtrailing. Oh, we got a red bad boy stuck up in there. I don't know if you're gonna pick him up. There he is in there. So they're gonna still keep on railing it up. Let me see if I can get a better look at him so you can see his red body. So it comes through that cloudoid that they've already built up. There he is. Trust me on this one, he's a red bad boy. They're still adding to the grid. Look at up here, all white wisps. Western sector completely black already. Another railer up here as they put the final touches on the mess that they made the last few days. And then the white sun blocked. More soot up there. As I pan around that northwestern sector, you can see it all starting to break apart. Now back on that northern sector, look at the fluff they got up over here. When that collapses, it's gonna be one nasty. Back on this guy, he's overhead now. He can tell he's a silver bullet. Blown plume, damn it. But back to this, look at that fluff. Take you right over the top, just like a chemtrailer. Just blowing the plume over the top. So they do it, some do underneath, some do over the top. Here's another prime example of what people think are clouds falling apart into white soot. Look, see the fluff on the top? You know what that looks like? I'm not even gonna mention it. So tired of it. But look at this. Look how it's all glowing in there, just falling apart on the edge. It was all once like this. Now it's all falling apart. And it's falling on top of the bottom black layer. So you can imagine when that hits, you might even get some fake hail. Who knows? Look at this leftover rail, how it's all dispersed. All right. I think that's about it for now. One more shot of this guy going overhead. Check out the plume. That's that same silver bullet now. Just heading into that western sector. And he's heading right into that. Can't let this go. Here's that red bad boy that went by. Now you can see his red body. He's way out there, but just let me show you what's going on here. There's the red bad boy. And then just alongside of him is this guy over here adding to the rail as he heads to the edge of that other chemtrail. See that? See how he's edging it alongside the edge there? Yeah. And then he's going to end up crossing his rail back over here. It's all done by design. They know exactly what they're doing. Back on the silver bullet. Look what he did. Now how in the hang can he turn? He must have different plumes. Look, he's got chain link. And the plume didn't chain link anywhere else. Look at that chain link. He's got tanker plume mixed in there. That's what's going on there. See how straight it is? He's got tank. Look how much brighter it looks. It's almost as if he had another canister turned on another tank, which is probably what he did. Back on that red bad boy, you can look what's happened here. He turned it off, or he's lost inside that wisp. Where this guy here, he went over the top, and he's just kind of adding. Hopefully when this disperses, he's probably thinking that it's going to blend in with that soot right there. Oh, look at this. I just can't let any of this go. Look at this configuration here. Look how this looks. It's real something, isn't it? And then over here you can see the white wisp as the cloudoid falls apart right in front of your eyes. And then up over here, got a CIA evergreen air. So you know if they're spraying like this right now? They were spraying all day. Back on that CIA evergreen air, look at over here where this guy's going. They're gonna meet at some point down over here. Right inside that soot. Going back to that eastern sector, as we close out the documentation for today, you can see how dark they've gotten it. And the hole in the grid that was up here just 15 minutes ago, almost completely covered. You got some really discolored blue in that eastern horizon. Look at it, it's almost a green blue. Now here, you gotta think to yourself, look, you can see it part of another grid in the background. You gotta ask yourself, if the sun is way over here on the opposite side in the western sector, going back over here, wouldn't the blue be darker? The answer is yes, but the geoengineering has gotten it so polluted that our cobalt blue sky is no longer. Back over here in the northern sector, look at this. Soot just falling. Look at the black globule there. You can see the different mixes as the stuff all blends together and comes raining down on mankind and Mother Earth. It's just pretty damn sad. Look at that black soot, just ready to fall. The rain has stopped, now it's just soot falling. It's just so amazingly sad. We'll leave you with a little look at some of the toxic plume. Now, a view of how it'd be looking if you were to go over the top with your own chemtrail jet. And that's how it would look. Have a good night, everybody.